Does email overwhelm you? Do you find that email actually gets in the way of you doing your best work? Well, after reading Getting Things Done by David Allen, I created my own email productivity system based on those principles. And in this video, I'm going to share my system with you. But before we start, just a quick intro. My name is Jonathan, also known as the Bearded 365 Guy. I help customers all over the world with their Microsoft 365. You check me out at bearded365guy.com. Now, I don't know about you, but email used to control my daily work life. On a Sunday, I'd sit down and I'd plan my week. It all looked so productive. But that all went out of the window on Monday morning, depending on what emails landed in my mailbox. All my mailbox was a giant to-do list. I'd leave an email in my mailbox as a reminder that I had a task to do. And the more often I saw that email and I'd not done the task, the more anxious I felt. Then the volume of emails in my mailbox just grew and grew and grew, and it made me feel worse, and I felt really unproductive. And this problem followed me everywhere. I'd have the Outlook app on my iPhone and my iPad, so when I'm out and about, I'd just keep looking at my emails, and I keep seeing my endless to-do list. I'd be replying to emails within 2 or 3 minutes of receiving them. Even when I went on holiday, the problem followed with me. I'd be on a sun lounger, I'd be looking at my mailbox, and my kids would be saying,
"Dad, you're always on your phone."
Plus, the biggest problem with all this is I wasn't doing any of the deep work that Cal Work talks about in his book, Deep Work. Cal Newport says that to do your best work, you've got to have periods where you're sitting down and concentrating on the task in front of you, without distractions. I got sick and tired of always being on. But then I read something online and it was this. Your mailbox isn't a task manager. It's just a tool that enables you to send and receive messages. Now this sounds incredibly simple, but it really stuck with me. I then started to read the famous productivity book called Getting Things Done by David Allen, and I loved it. So I decided to sit down and create my own email productivity system based on his principles. And that is what I'm going to show you in today's video. So let's get started with the content. Now, the first thing you need to do with the email productivity system is create some Outlook categories. Now, this works really well if you're using the new Outlook or Outlook Web Access, but you can still do it in the traditional Outlook. Now, to start with, we're going to create three categories, one called Next Actions, one called Waiting For, and one called Reading. Now, you might find that you create new categories as you go on with this system, but these three categories are great to start you off. Let me show you how to do that. Okay, I am logged in to Outlook Web Access, which looks pretty much the same as the new Outlook. So if I want to add some categories, what I can do is go up to this little wrench at the top, which is Settings. I can go to the General tab, and I've got Categories here. And you can see I've got all my categories listed here. Now, these are just the Microsoft standard ones. So the choice I've got here is I can click on the pencil, and I can rename these, and I can recolor these. Or I can click on Create Category, and I can create a new one. So I will do. I call this Next Actions. I'll give that a colour and I'll click on Save. What I'll also do is I'll amend this to see how it's done, and I will call this Waiting For, and I'll click on Save. Now the final category I'm going to create, which I will do for this yellow one, and I'm going to call this Reading. You can call it Reading or Newsletters or whatever you want, and I'll click on Save. Now the crucial thing, and this feature only works in the new Outlook, is we can favourite our categories. So if I go to Next Actions and I click on the star, if I go to Reading and Waiting For and I click on the stars, you can see something has happened behind the scenes here. If I just close out of there, you can see that I have now favorited these categories. So these appear in Outlook. Now the favoriting of categories isn't available in the old Outlook, but I've got that open here. So this is the old Outlook. If you want to create some categories here, you can see there's just a categorize at the top. We can go to All Categories, we can click on New, and we can create our categories. and give them a colour, okay? But we can't favourite them. So that is a good feature about the new Outlook. So we've now got our categories created. Next up, you're going to decide at what intervals during the day you're going to process emails. Then you're going to add that as a recurring event in your calendar. Now, the thing is, with this email productivity system, you don't have your Outlook open all day. You just get distracted. So what you're going to do is have regular intervals where you process emails. Now, you'll be amazed by the results. When I started out with my system, I used to process emails 4 times every day. First thing in the morning, just before lunch, mid-afternoon, and after work. I then found this was too many times. And believe me, I get a lot of emails and I've got a lot to do. So as it stands now, I process emails 2 per day, first thing in the morning and after work. Now, email processing time can take about 30 minutes, or on a good day, it can take about 5 minutes. My days are now fully planned and I get more work done. Now, you might be sat there thinking, no way, no way I can do this. But just trust me, try it for a week. If you need to process email more than 4 times a day, do it. But just get into the habit of having email processing time. And if you're really brave, you could delete the email app off your smartphone. Let me just show you how to schedule email processing time in your calendar. Okay, again, I'm in the new Outlook. So if I just hop over to my calendar, I can click on new event and I can call this process email. Okay, so if I'm going to do this every morning at 7 o'clock, let's say, the first date is going to be tomorrow, which is Monday. It's going to take me half an hour. And then I can put this on repeat. So I can choose daily. I can remove Saturday and Sunday. And that happens every day. I click on save and I save that appointment. And you can see now every morning at 7 a.m. during the week, I'll be processing emails. Now we can add a second appointment. So what we can do here, again, we're going to start that tomorrow. And this time I'll be doing it at the end of the workday. Again, it takes half an hour. We'll repeat that daily. We'll remove Saturday and Sunday. It repeats. I'll click that and I'll save that. So now twice a day, I am going to be processing email. I've got an event in my calendar. It's an appointment with myself. So now let's move on to the meat of the content. This is the email productivity system. This is how we process emails. This is how I process emails 2 per day. At the processing time, I sit down and I open my mailbox and then I work from oldest to newest. The first thing I do is if the email is junk, I delete it. Nice and simple. Next up, if the email in front of me takes less than 2 minutes to respond to, then I will respond to it there and then. Once I've responded to it, I will archive that email away in my Outlook archive folder. So it's out of my mailbox and out of my mind. Let me show you how. Now in Outlook, we've got an archive function, okay? You can see the option here in the top taskbar, and you can see the folder here. Now, if I open this email here, again, you can see the archive option is here. So this is an email. It's inviting me to an event. Perhaps I don't want to go to the event. So this email is going to take me less than 2 minutes to simply respond to it. I will reply. Something like that, and I can simply send that email. Once I've sent that email, I can simply keep that highlighted, and I can click on archive. Okay, that email has now been archived out of my mailbox, but it's not disappeared forever. It's just simply gone into the archive folder. So it's this one here. So if I ever need to go back, I can simply go into the archive folder, or what I can also do is use the search function at the top of the screen. So that is for emails that just take 2 minutes or less to respond to. Next up, if the next email takes me more than 2 minutes to respond to, perhaps I've got to write a sales proposal or something like that, and that will take longer than 2 minutes. The next question that I ask myself is this: am I the right person to be doing this task, or can I delegate it? Now, if I can delegate this task, then I will forward that email on to the right person and I will ask them if they can do the task. But next, and crucially, I will categorize that email with the category called waiting for, because I'm waiting for that other person to complete the task. Once I've categorized that email, again, I'll archive it away into the Outlook archive folder. Let me show you how that works. Okay, back in my mailbox here, what I've got here is an email, it's a report. Okay, I'm not going to do anything with this, but what I am going to do is delegate it. So if I delegate that to someone else, okay, I can say, and then I can send that email. So I am now waiting for Simon to do that. So what I can also do now is use my categories. So I will categorize this email as waiting for, okay, and then I will archive it. So again, it's disappeared out of my mailbox. It's gone into the archive folder. But crucially, it is now in the waiting for here. So what's going to end up happening is I will have a list of emails that I am waiting for someone else to action, okay? More on that later when we talk about the daily planner and the weekly review. But for now, this is how we delegate tasks. Now hang about until the end of this video when I talk about the daily plan, and you'll see how we keep track of all those waiting for tasks. Now, let's move on to those other tasks. They take longer than 2 minutes, plus we can't delegate them. So it's a task that we have to do. Now, this is where the integration between Microsoft Outlook and Microsoft To Do, or Planner as it is known now, comes in. Now, remember, our inbox is not a task manager. So what we do now with that email is we move it over from our mailbox into our to-do. We can just drag and drop it. I'll show you in a moment. Once we've moved that over to our to-do, we can categorize that email with next actions. And then we can archive the email away so it's no longer in our inbox. Now, remember, we're not doing tasks at this point. All we're doing is processing email. Again, we'll talk about when we do tasks later on in the video. But for now, let me show you the process of how you move tasks into your task manager. Back in my mailbox now. Now, all these items in my mailbox, they're just test emails. They're actually all just kind of junk emails that I could delete. But just pretend for a moment, all these emails are tasks that take over 2 minutes to complete and I can't delegate them. So I've got to do them. How would I process these emails? Well, what I would do, so if I open this one here, you can see I need to do something with this. So what I would do is I would pull out the to-do integration, which is this tab here, and that pulls out my to-do. So what I would next do is I would drag this over to here, which would add that as a task. The next thing I would do is I would right click on it and I would probably edit the title of this. Okay, so I might put something like that. I would then okay that. The next part of this is the category. So I can open the email like this and I can categorize it. Or what I could do, I can just simply right click on it. I can go to categorize and then I would add this to next actions because it's a task that I've got to complete. What I'll then do is because it's highlighted here, I can go to the top and I can archive it away. So again, it's gone out of my mailbox. It's a to-do item in my to-do list. And also, if I go to next actions, it's there. So the purpose of this next action category is just to keep those next action items at my fingertips so I can access them easily. I will then go and do the same for a few others. Okay, and then the rest of these are just junk, so I can delete them. So now I've processed my email, I've got a clear inbox, I've got items in my to-do list. And you can also see, if I look at my to-do list, there's also a little link. So what I can do if I want to get back to the original email is simply click on here, view email, and it takes me straight to the email. So there's a bit of a connection between the task and the original email. So clean inbox, items in my to-do list, and I've also got a copy of all these emails in my next actions. It's looking pretty good. What do we do next? At the end of your email processing time, you will have a completely clear inbox and you'll feel great. But how do you do the tasks that you need to do? How do you follow up on the waiting for that you've delegated to someone else? Well, there are two other crucial aspects of this productivity system. There's the daily planning and the weekly review. So let's first start talking about the daily plan. So every day you will need to do something called the daily plan. Now this takes about 20 to 25 minutes. Now some people prefer to do this at the end of the day. It kind of completes the work day. I prefer to do mine at 6 a.m. So I do it with a cup of coffee and I plan my day. So what do I do with my daily planning session? Well, let me show you. So here I am, pretend it's 6 a.m. in the morning and I'm sitting down to do my daily planning. So this again doesn't take very long because I'm always keeping up to my system. What I will typically do on my daily planning session is I will go to my waiting for to start with. And I'll look at all the tasks that I'm waiting for. Now, if I've had responses off any of these tasks in here, what I will simply do is open it up. I can categorize it as something else. So if it's done with, I can clear the category. I can archive the email away that is done with. If I've not heard back from this and I'm still waiting for it and I really do need to hear back from it, then I will send a follow-up email saying, have you got an update on this task? It will obviously then stay in the waiting for folder. I will then go into reading. We've not really covered reading, but what this would be, I get a lot of newsletters and things into my mailbox, and what I do is I categorize them as reading. So there might be a time every week where I sit down and I read those. I've then got to plan my day. So I've obviously got the to-do integration here, but I want to work in the full to-do. So I will close out of that, and I will go to this to-do box here. And that will open the full to-do. Now you can see here, those tasks that I added into the Outlook plugin have now appeared in here. So I would go through all my tasks and I would start to plan my day. And this is why I do it at 6 a.m. Now there's just three tasks here. In my real world, there are a lot more. But I might look at this and think, well, there's a training session here. I can click into there. And I can think, well, I don't need to do anything with this for a good week. So I can add a due date. I can pick a date and I can say, well, put this for the 21st. This is Friday. Now, what that will do is this task will pop into my day next Friday. Okay, so I don't have to do anything about that. The publish the TikTok video, well, that's a little bit more important. That needs to be done today. So I will simply add that to my day. And the event as well, I need to book that as well. So I will add that to my day as well. So once I've finished my daily plan, I can simply go to my day and there will be a list of all the tasks that I need to complete during today. I'm not working in email all day. I'm just focusing on the tasks that I've added to my day. Nice and simple. So once I've got my day planned, I know what's ahead of me. I can finally just go back into my mailbox and I can go to the next actions category. Now, if there's any emails in here for tasks yesterday that I've now completed, I can simply take them out of this category. So pretend I've completed this one. I can then remove the category from this and that will disappear out of there, but it will still be available in the archive folder. So I'm all set up now, ready to be super productive during today. Now, secondly, what you will want to add as well, again, put this as a recurring event in your calendar, is a weekly review. Some people like to do this on a Friday afternoon. It kind of closes off the week. Some people like to do it on a Saturday or a Sunday morning when there's no distractions. The weekly review is a bit more higher level. It's a bit different from the daily plan. With the weekly review, you might review the week that has gone past. You might look at what went well, what didn't go as well. You also look at the following week. You might look at your calendar items, what meetings you have. But you'll also have a bit of an outline as to some of the tasks that you want to complete. Some of the tasks that will move your goals forward. So that is it. That is my email system based on Getting Things Done by David Allen. Why don't you give it a try? It could really improve your productivity. I look forward to seeing you again soon.